world. Welcome to episode 16 of the Knit Up River podcast. My name is Carrie and I am the dyer behind Yakagani Yarns. This is a podcast about knitting, crocheting, and just in general of my crafty ventures and my shop. I'm coming to you as always from my home in southwestern Pennsylvania where I live with my husband Todd and our boxer Tonka. I don't know if he'll make an appearance today or not. He's laying on the floor over here to the side and he just let a great big sigh. It's such a tough life being a pampered dog. Today happens to be Saturday, September 2nd, so happy Shaltember for those of you who are celebrating. If you are a returning viewer, thank you so much for coming back to spend a little bit of time with me today. And if you are a new viewer, welcome. I hope you enjoy what you see. You can find me on Instagram as @YakYarns. On Ravelry as Carrie Jean, and I also have a Yakagani Yarns Ravelry group, as well as a Facebook page for Yakagani Yarns and an online Etsy store and website. So, I am going to jump right in with finished objects. And for those of you who are returning viewers, you may see behind me the big thing blowing out the camera there. I finished my crocheted wedding blanket. I'll move to the side here so you can see it. This is the Sunny Spread by Ellen Gormley. I crocheted it with just some white acrylic yarn that is in my stash. Today is the wedding. I'm going to be getting ready here in a little bit to go do that. So I'll be packaging it up and giving it to the bride and groom. And I really hope they like it. That was part of the reason I went with acrylic. I wanted something that they could throw in the washer, throw in the dryer, and not have to worry about felting it, because I'm not sure that they're very fiber savvy. My husband guarantees me that they will love it. It's actually a very simple pattern. You crochet each of these squares individually, join them together. The pattern calls for 8 rows of 8 blocks. I stopped at 6 rows of 8 blocks and it still made a nice size spread. I'm not going to try to hold it up. It's massive, fairly massive. It's a good couch throw, something you'll throw over your legs and want to leave on the couch, and it's a little cool. So that is that one that's finished. Back in the middle there. Okay. The other one that I finished, I am actually wearing. This is my Swatara shawl from Liverpool Yarns. It was actually, I think, written by Erica Flory. And I knit this in Yak Sock, which is yarn I dye. It's a fingering weight, 100% superwash merino yarn. The colors that I used, the pink one here in the middle is Dogwood, and then I paired it with Chestnut. So it's a very, very nice sized shawl, and I love the detailing. It's done in a traditional, based on the traditional Hap shawl. So you actually start it, let me see, I'll put this up here, and you knit this whole center piece, and then once the center piece is completed, you go back and you pick up stitches along the edge here and do the ripple border. Very, very pleased with the way this turned out. It is a paid for pattern, and I will have a link to that in the show notes. You can go ahead and get that, but I'm so thrilled. The yarn, like I said, it is 100% superwash merino, and oh my god, you guys, this is so squishy. I know it's yarn I dye, but I really do like this base. It's actually very, very squishy and warm. So instead of trying to put that back around there, I'm just gonna do this one for now. I don't have any other pictures of it. My husband's been working kind of late, and I don't have anybody else to help me take pictures at the moment. So last night till he got home, it was dark, and today they're calling for us to have some pretty nasty wind and rain going on. Right now it's windy as all get out, but the rain hasn't found us yet, so fingers crossed that it kind of misses us. I guess this is the remnants of Harvey that are coming up through Pennsylvania right now. So that's all I have as far as finished objects. I was actually thrilled to get both of these done since I talked to you last. It made me super excited. Yay! It's It's always such a good feeling when you finish those massive projects that have been languishing for a while. So on to my works in progress. The first one I'm going to show you is actually residing in my Diary of a Yarn Snob DYS bag. Hi, Julie, if you're watching. I got this bag last year. And this project keeps traveling back and forth to different project bags depending on what kind of a mood I'm in. These are based on the Afterthought Heels Revisited pattern by Laura Linneman, which is a free pattern on Ravelry. It is a toe-up Afterthought Heel sock. I am knitting this with one of the Yakagini yarns, Two Man River Raft. Now, what that means, this is a sock blank that is double knit. It is designed for two at a time socks. See, I've got two strands there coming off the sock blank. When these socks are done, I think I explained this last time, you will have identical twins. Where with a typical sock blank, you would have fraternal twins instead. They would go together, but they would not match. These ones will match. So I'm working on these for my husband, and the little blue skull is where I was at the last time I showed them to you. Since we've talked, I have put in the pink thread that you're seeing there is actually where I'm going to pick stitches up on either side to put my Afterthought Heel in, and then I'll take that pink out. It's just scrap yarn holding my place. And then I'm doing a simple knit 3 purl 3 rib for the leg, because if you are a returning viewer, you've heard me make a comment before, my husband has incredibly skinny ankles. He stands 6'1", and there's no other way to put it, he kind of has chicken legs sometimes, especially down on his ankles. His calves are nicely formed, but his ankles are super skinny. It's ridiculous. So I needed something to, you know, pull it in and make sure it's going to stay up on his leg, because I don't want him to have handmade socks that are slouchy and slipping down around his ankles. But, so progress has been made on those. I did a little bit of car knitting on these last weekend. We ran away for the weekend very quickly. But, pleased with how they're coming out. If you look really closely, it's hard to see in this light. You know, the lighting's not the greatest. I apologize for that, but it is kind of striping. There we go. You can see it's not a horrible stripe. It's not an obvious one. But the sock blank itself, there we go. Now, all of my sock blanks are one of a kind. I'm not going to be able to repeat them. So, unfortunately, guys, this one is not going to be coming back. He gets first dibs. He's the reason I do it. So, yeah. For the heel, when I go back to put it in, I'm actually going to use chestnut, which is just one of my Mon sock minis. So I figured that would go very well. Nice masculine type of sock. It's a fall thing. I like brown. You can see that. Warm autumnal colors. But, so that was the first one. And then Thursday, because I had finished this, I permitted myself to cast on something new. I still only have two works in progress, so I'm behaving myself. I haven't gotten starditis yet. I can't say it won't happen. There's a few other sweaters that I've been eyeballing, and one that I do would like to try to at least get started for a Christmas gift for my husband, so we'll see. As well as a shawl that I need to get cast on for a Christmas gift. You know, I'll get there. It's okay. All is good. I have the pattern and the yarn picked out. Does that count? But I cast on. I've been eyeing this sweater for a while and eyeballing the yarn in my stash for a long time. So I'm casting on Boxy by Hohe Locatelli. It's a fingering weight, big boxy, oversized sweater, which is what I like for winter. That way I can layer things up as I get cold. And I am using yarn. I've had this yarn, I calculate, in my stash for like 5, maybe 6 years. I know there's people, there's some of you out there have had yarn in your stash much longer, so don't judge me. Just don't do it. But the first I have four skeins in here. The first two are ones I picked up at a Pittsburgh Knit and Crochet Festival long before I started dyeing from Space Cadet Yarn Company. Okay, Space Cadet Creations. Stephanie for Pittsburgh usually dyes a special colorway, and this is on her Celeste base, which is 100% superwash merino, 490 yards. Okay. And this was the Northern Lights colorway. You can see it's got the burgundies and the greens. There's pops of blue. Trust me, there's green in there. It's not showing up very well on the camera. But there's also little pops of red and gold, turquoise. So I had two skeins of this. And then every year in Pittsburgh, there is a little show in just off the Swissville exit called Indie Knit and Spin. And I, again, went to it long before I ever started dyeing. But Stephanie was there again, and she had a bunch of one-of-a-kind skeins. So again, this is her Celeste base, 490 yards, fingering weight, superwash merino. And Department of Rocket Science is what she calls her one-of-a-kind skeins. These are generally one-offs. I don't know, she's testing colors. I'm guessing that's what it was. And I found two that were pretty darn close. One's a little bit lighter than the other one, but when they were in the skein, they ended up in stash next to this guy. And while they're not identical and they don't have all those little pops of color that Northern Lights does, there's enough of the same colors in there that I wondered if I were to change my skein and essentially stripe it every two rows, would I be able to make the sweater work? Would it look okay? Would you be able to tell? So I tried it. And it's hard to see because this is small, but it's actually working up very well. And it does, you really can't tell that it's not all the same yarn. So, there we go. I'm quite pleased with this. I like how it's turning out. I think it's going to be a great autumn, winter, spring kind of sweater. Multi-season, because it's fingering weight. I love the fabric and the way it's working up. Let me see if I can find one. There are these little, there's one. These tiny little pops of red that every once in a while just go bam, and there they are. Come on. There it is. There's my red. You see it? But yeah, there's enough of the burgundy and that funky cadet kind of blue in there that I'm quite thrilled with this. Like I said, if I didn't know that was two yarns, I wouldn't be able to tell. What do you guys think? I'm going to continue working on it. I'm having a blast. Like I said, I just started this. This is Saturday. I started this Thursday evening at about 8:30. I've been kind of obsessed with it. And just so you're aware, I'm knitting what would be the adult small, not the extra small. So each round here has 390 stitches in it. So for me to sit down and do two rounds every now and again takes quite a while, but that's okay. I know it's going to be a long-term project, and I'm all right with that. It is residing in my new Whimsy Stitches bags with my comment bubbles. And yes, I have four skeins in there. Yay! Currently have the sweater in there too. Not sure how long it's going to be able to reside in there because as it gets bigger, I know it's going to take up more room. But I'm going to keep it in there for as long as I can because I'm really digging my bag. Thank you, Rick. I don't know if you watch, but thank you so much. It's an awesome bag, and I'm loving it, and it's holding my boxy, my current favorite project. So, that's all I have for whips. I'm trying to be good here. I may have another one that I've cast, excuse me, itchy eyeball. May have to cast on another one soon, because I do have a Christmas gift that I need to get knit for somebody. No, I'm not saying who it's for. Because I don't know if she watches. I don't think she does. But just on the off chance. It's okay. We're going to let it slide. I also picked up the pattern. I don't know if you guys have seen it, by Hohe Locatelli. She released a new pattern just a couple weeks ago called the Long Line Cardigan. So I may have to cast that one on too. I'm really trying to avoid the start edits here because I don't want to have too many things on the needles. It gets overwhelming. But that one, trying to decide what color I want to do it in, because I have a couple options. I can discuss the one, but I can't quite discuss the other one because I haven't put it up in the store yet. So that one may have to wait till next time. But I've been very, very good. I have not been buying any yarn online. It's been tempting. Oh my goodness. Between the Yarn Enabler and the Cozy Knitter. You guys are evil. Come on. Quit. You keep posting all these awesome colorways and it's killing me here. I'm very, very trying hard to be very, very good. But I did go through and do a stash assessment recently. If you guys haven't seen, Rick from Whimsy Stitches has been organizing, he and a friend of his, it's called Knit Two Together for Texas. They are taking signups from knitters who are not affected by Harvey to donate stash replacement packages to knitters and crocheters who may have been affected by Harvey. So if you were hit by Harvey and you're seeing this, there is a group on Ravelry. Again, it's called Knit Two Together for Texas. You can go. There's a Google form you fill out if you are in need of stash. But if you're a knitter or crocheter or spinner, you can donate spinning supplies too. There is another form you can fill out to donate. And after the people affected are, you know, they're kind of getting back on their feet, it may take 6 to 8 weeks, they said, to get all of this organized and everybody paired up. But once the people who were affected have a mailing address that they can receive packages and things, they're going to go through the list of people who are signing up to donate and they will pair you with somebody so you can put together a package for specifically for that person and send it to them. I think it's a nice idea. I know everybody, you know, if you can't do that, that's not able, please donate money. Cash is really, really what they need. As far as, because they can use the cash to go buy the food and the clothes and the other supplies. So I encourage everybody to, you know, just chip in, help out. Last year around this time was when our hometown got hit by unexpected and very severe flooding. So my heart is going out to everybody there, and I have signed up to donate a package. I know how much comfort I get from my knitting and my crocheting and my crafting. And even the concept of losing my stash and the ability to have that comfort on hand when I need it most, I can't even imagine. So, anyhow, didn't expect to go into that. That was not in the show notes, but there you go. It's out there now. So, I really only have one acquisition that came in after I recorded the last episode. I'm referring to my show notes so that I get it. Wanda from Twisted Yarn and Fiber. Hi, Wanda. I don't know if you watch. But she had posted in her shop this adorable little bag, and I had to have it. I had to have it, even if it's for a giveaway. I still had to have it. This is one of her drawstring bags. Aww. And you guys, I have to show you a close-up of this fabric. Oh my goodness. Zombie sheep! Okay. I'm not a huge horror fan. However, we have recently discovered a TV show called iZombie. I don't know if you have watched it. I think it's in its third season. I could be wrong. I'm kind of loving this character because it's not a gory, nasty, gross kind of zombie thing. I don't get into those ones. But it's quirky, it's funny, it's different, which is kind of what I like. And when I saw the zombie sheep bag, it's quirky, it's funny, it's different. I had to have the zombie sheep bag. So yeah, It's a nice big bag. It is completely lined. I don't have her business card, but I'm going to show you. There's the tag, twisted yarn and fiber. And there's her website. I will put a link in the show notes like I always do. Alright. Yeah, you guys, you need to go check her bags out. She has some really, really pretty ones, some really quirky ones, and they're just fun. So that was my only acquisition. Just bobbing around here. Since I talked to you guys last, it's been about 2 weeks. I did stick to my schedule that I wanted. I did release my Halloween colors. They are in the shop under limited release. I released two of them. You have the Great Pumpkin and Monster Mash. If you are hoping to get your hands on one and you're not going to see me at a festival before Halloween, you might want to head on over and order them, because November 1st, they're gone. I'll be taking them out of the shop. So just a heads up there. But other than that, we did take an end of summer trip out to Hershey Park, which is in Pennsylvania, out near Harrisburg. I'd never been there before. We went with my husband's cousin and his wife. We had so much fun. I am a coaster junkie. I love riding roller coasters. Most of the other amusement park rides I can do without. Some of them I'll get on, some of them it's like, meh, I don't need them. But I love riding coasters. And Hershey Park has a ton of awesome coasters. So we had a really good day there. I was kind of surprised, being Hershey Park, that there would be more of a focus on chocolate. And there really wasn't a whole lot of chocolate anywhere. It was a little disappointing. I had to actually go in search of fudge in order to bring something chocolate home. Yeah, they had all the bag candies and whatnot in the gift shops, but I can go to the grocery store and buy those. I figured you'd have something a little more interesting there. So that was a little bit of a letdown. But as far as an amusement park goes, it was really, really worth the trip. If you are an amusement park fan like what we are and haven't been there, you need to make a plan and go there. The coasters are awesome. Totally worth the trip. But other than that, I have just been working on some dyeing and getting ready for my upcoming festivals and things like that. Have talked to Madison. She is doing well. So far the storms, most of them have missed her. She, for those of you who are new and may not understand, our daughter is in the United States Air Force. She is stationed down in Panama City, Florida right now, right on the coast of the Gulf. So hurricane season, I'm a little concerned, but she says, most of the storms are going around them. They haven't been really affected by anything. So, whew, thankful for that. But yeah, she's doing well. Todd and I are planning a trip with his mom to go down and see her in November. So that is fun. I can't wait to see the kid. She's excited. She's a tiny little thing. She only stands about 5'4", and when she went into the Air Force, she had a problem maintaining weight to meet the minimum requirements. So she was excited the other day. She called. She said, "I had to tell you, Mom, I had to tell you, I'm up to 120 pounds. Which for her is a huge achievement. So, but yeah, she's doing well, and that's, all good there. Not worried about that. As far as cooking and baking, I haven't been doing a whole lot. It's been hot. We have been doing some canning, so I don't have any recipes to share with you. Todd and I are also in the middle of kind of an adjustment. I don't know if I mentioned it on the podcast before, but we have decided to go, I guess you would call it, semi-vegetarian. 3 days a week specifically, we are eating non-meat meals, strictly vegetarian, not vegan. There is a difference. Strictly vegetarian. And what that means is vegetarian, eggs, cheese, dairy products, that kind of stuff are still on the menu. It's simply the meat that has been taken off on those 3 days. And then the other 3 days a week, we do have meat in the meal, but I'm trying to cut back on the amount that we're eating. And then the seventh day of the week is optional. It's up to us if we eat meat or not. So, but we kind of left that one open. That way, if we're here at home and we have leftovers that need to be cleaned up, or if we're going, you know, out like today to a wedding, Saturday tends to be the option day. It leaves us a bit more flexibility and room to wiggle room there to kind of work things around. So I'm still adjusting to that, finding new recipes. So if any of you are vegetarians out there and have some recipes you would like to share with me, please do so. You can always email them to me. It's yakyarns@gmail.com, or, you know, just leave a link in the comment section below. I'm always open to new recipes. I like trying new things. My husband's biggest complaint about my cooking is that he rarely gets the same meal twice. As far as crafting content, that is all I have for this week. From this point forward, we're going to be talking about my upcoming festival schedule for the business and any shop updates, the Ravelry group, that kind of thing. If you are not interested in that, I am perfectly okay with that, and I will talk to you next time. If you're sticking around, let's proceed. So, once again, upcoming festivals coming up September 9th and 10th, which is next weekend. We will be at the Hunterdon County Fairgrounds in Lambertville, New Jersey for the Garden State Sheep Breeders Annual Fiber Festival. It runs Saturday the 9th from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. and Sunday the 10th from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. We will be located in barn number 4, but there are a ton of other vendors that are going to be there, so I encourage you, come on out. Please, if you're coming to the festival, swing by the booth, say hi, introduce yourself. I love meeting people in person and talking to them, you know, kind of putting faces with IDs that I may see online. Doesn't always happen, but we will be there. I'm excited. I've never been to New Jersey, so hoping all goes well and the weather holds out, we don't end up with a big, you know, storm coming up the coast or anything, because that could be bad. But after that, we have the Sip and Stitch at the coffee shop in Blairsville, Pennsylvania. Yes, somebody had messaged me on Facebook. I cannot remember her name, but yes, I do know where Blairsville is. I have lived in southwestern Pennsylvania all of my life. My best friend actually lives in Derry, so hi Vicky, and she will be there with me. She's the one who kind of spurred this whole thing and introduced me to Karen, the woman who owns the coffee shop. But that will be from 10 a.m. until noon. It's not a huge Sip and Stitch, but I encourage you to get up a little early, come have some coffee with us, bring your crocheting, bring your knitting, hang out for a little bit. I will have a special colorway that I am, you know, doing just for the coffee shop. I will have a limited number of skeins, so if you want one, you need to come find me at the coffee shop that day. And I will be previewing three new yarn bases. I'm not talking about those specifically on this podcast today, but I will warn you, I am previewing, which means they won't be fully launched, but I will have a few skeins of these three new yarn bases for you guys to see, to squish, to buy, to adore. Let's see what else. Again, that's on Saturday, September 23rd, 10 a.m. to noon at the coffee shop in Blairsville. Then on Saturday, September 30th, I'm teaching an afterthought heel class at Rags Fiber Art in Forbes Road, PA. The class will run from, it starts at 2, and I think her website says 5, goes until 5, it's either 4 or 5, I can't remember. As long as it takes, I'll stay there and help you. I know 2 people were signed up, there are a limited number of spots available, so if you like making socks, but you hate doing the heel flap, turning the heel, and then picking up the gusset stitches, please, I encourage you, check out Tony's website. I will have a link in the notes, you know, the show notes, on how to get in touch with her, because you have to contact her. Tony is the owner of Rags Fiber Arts, but you have to contact her to sign up for this class. Don't contact me. I have no information, you know, about it all. I can tell you when it is, I can tell you what I'm teaching, but to sign up for it, you have to contact Tony at Rags Fiber Arts. So there are still spots available for that, and I encourage you to come out. It's going to be fun. So, and it's not that hard. I promise. Okay. What else did we have going on? Over in the Ravelry group. I'm going to shift gears there. That's everything that's going on for September. I'll talk about the October stuff probably on the next episode. Let's see. Over in the Ravelry group, we hit 100 members. Woo! And I did have a giveaway for those of you who were paying attention. The winner from that was Ellie from West Virginia. She got to choose the bass for it. She had picked, I had asked Mary Wood for that giveaway. I had posted real quick, it was just over the weekend, but I had posted, you know, tell me what your favorite Yakagini yarn is, whether it was your color or the base or whatever. But she had posted that she was in love with the Great Pumpkin, which was one of the Halloween colors that I did. So she won a skein of that, and she was looking forward to making some socks. So yay! Make sure you post pictures, Ellie. I can't wait to see what they look like. Other Ravelry group news, we have a knit and crochet along currently running. It began on July 1st and is going until the end of September. It is our shawl along. You can use any pattern that you want. You can use any weight of yarn that you want, but you have to use at least 100 grams of yarn in order to qualify. You get bonus entries for using Yakagini yarn. So you don't have to necessarily use my yarn in order to participate in this one. Currently we have 12 entries. That's it. The field is still kind of small. So, if you are working on a shawl that you just started in July or have recently picked up the stitches for, please, you know, all you have to do is complete your shawl. You put a picture of the finished shawl in the thread, and then I'm tracking all of the eligible entries. I encourage you to go over there. Right now, all of the entries we have, I believe, are knit. There is no crochet going on. And I would like to pick a winner for both, one knit winner and one crochet winner. I just need to know, you know, what's going on there. So, but yeah, other shop news, there, like I had, did say there are new bases coming. I do have new colorways that I'm working on. Not all of them are quite ready to be revealed yet, but they're coming. And I'm working on my holiday colors. It's been a little hectic, but that's okay. I will get them done soon. And I'm hoping to actually have something posted either next week or maybe the week after. Follow me on Instagram or follow the Facebook page. That's generally where I put the new stuff up. Instagram more than anything. What else? The last thing I want to give you guys a heads up on are I am working with Wanda from Twisted Yarn and Fiber on a special holiday collaboration. That's about all I can tell you. It will be a bag and yarn, but I'm not revealing any more about it at the moment. It is coming at the beginning of October, so stay tuned for that. And I believe that's all I have for this week. If you have any questions, there is an Ask Me Anything thread in the Ravelry group. You can post them there and I will either respond back to you or I will answer them on the next podcast episode. Comments, anything like that, leave them below. I would love to hear from you. And until next time, guys, happy crafting!